going on, everyone? Welcome to another episode on Let's Talk Battles with Uche. I am your host, Uche. Everyone who's been supporting me, thank you so much as usual. If you're new to my podcast, please make sure to download, subscribe, and share with your friends and family. If you're new to my YouTube channel, also make sure to subscribe and hit that bell notification so anytime I upload a video, you'll be the very first to be notified. So for today's episode, I wanted to review, or at least give my own opinion about the whole Lil Nas X music video, Call Me By My Name, or Call My Name, or something like that. Montero, Call Me By My Name.
You got it, you know that you can. Call me when you want, call me when you need. Call me in the morning, I'll be on the way. Call me when you want, call me when you need. Call me out by your name, I'll be on the way. Like,
before I get started, I do want to give a quick disclaimer for all the Christians, all the religious fanatics, all the Christian religious people who have some type of problem with the song because it portrays homosexuality, or it's very inappropriate or explicit or whatnot, you know, because it has something to do with homosexuality. All of y'all folks can eat a dick. Again, to all the religious Christian people who have some type of problem because it has homosexuality, or it has something to do with queer or man being flamboyant or being sexual or whatnot, again, you can all eat dick, okay? And the reason why I'm saying this is, if you've been following my podcast, I don't have a problem with religion. I don't have anything against Christianity. I was raised Christian myself until I just chose not to be religious anymore. But at the same time, too, I personally don't have a problem with religiosity or religion or Christianity or whatnot. I just don't. However, I do have a problem with certain kinds of religious people, you know, who act like their shit don't stink. Personally, I have a problem with anybody who act like their shit don't stink. I have a problem with anybody who thinks they're better than anybody else. The self-righteous, overly pretentious, you know, I'm better than you because Jesus got me. All those Jesus people, y'all know exactly the kind of people I'm talking about. You know, those self-righteous, pretentious, you know, can't tell them nothing, you know, because they are holier than thou. Obnoxious, irritating to the T. Those are the people I'm talking about. I have a problem with all of y'all. And especially because y'all be some of the biggest hypocrites. I realize a lot of times you will see people who are some of the biggest sinners. They'll be into some of the most nefarious shit that you can actually think of, but when it comes to homosexuality, when it comes to chastising somebody who is homosexual, who's gay, they'll be the first people to start talking shit, you know, completely forgetting the fact that you are not perfect. You got all kinds of shit. It could be a womanizer, it could be a person who does drugs, alcohol, all kinds of fuck shit, and nothing necessarily wrong with those things, but by your logic, you are discriminating against somebody else because they're gay, but you got all kinds of fuck shit going on. Those are the people I'm addressing. Y'all can eat a dick. I've lost count how many times I've heard or read LGBTQ people, queer people being told that they're going to hell, they're going to burn in hell. Nobody has ever had the balls to tell me that shit to my face. I'm the type of dude that'll curse you clean the fuck out, and then I'll show you where to sit. I've heard so many times where, you know, it's always the religious people, the pastors, and somebody in the church, or some family member or a friend, acquaintance, a coworker, or something like that, always try to bring the Bible or try to tell a queer person, an LGBTQ member, that they're going to hell, that they're burning in hell. Yeah, I can eat a dick. Now, that being said, this is my actual honest opinion about the whole song production, music video, and everything. The beat was dope. You know, I listened to it the first time. I was bopping to it. I could definitely see myself bumping to this, you know, at the gym, driving or whatnot. You know, I downloaded it to my iPhone. I like the beat. I thought it was really dope. I was rocking with it. I was really with it. The lyrics, I went ahead, I googled the lyrics, I went through the lyrics. The lyrics didn't really do much for me, you know. It was talking about drugs and sex and I think alcohol, you know, something about weed and cocaine, and then I want to grab on your ass in Hawaii, something like that. So again, sex and drugs and alcohol, and you know, bragging about what I have, what you don't have. These lyrics, like I've said before, are mediocre to me, and this is no shade against Lil Nas, you know, and I'm not trying to sound like a hypocrite either, because I have a lot of these songs on my iPhone. You know, this is what sells. A lot of these music producers, they keep producing these songs because that's what people want to consume. You know, when there's a demand, there's supply. So I can't necessarily knock him for being a smart businessman, making a smart move. So I totally get it. That's what's selling. That's what people want to hear. So a lot of times, a lot of these pop songs, songs, your favorite artists, the rappers, all these people, they always talking about sex, big this, big that, how much I have, how much you don't have, my bitch is light skin, your bitch is dark skin. To me personally, I think that's all mediocre. However, I understand, you know, that's what the people want to hear, and that's what the artists are giving them. When I was watching the music video, I thought the music video was okay. You know, the animation, the CGI, I thought it was okay. Lil Nas X, I think he's an A-list celebrity now. He used to be a nobody. I think he blew up like a year or two ago after he did that Old Time Road. I think that's the name of the song. So he went from being a nobody to an A-list celebrity, or maybe a B-list celebrity, considering the fact that he is a top celebrity right now. I was expecting that he would spend more money for a better CGI. I've seen CGI effects that look so realistic, so dope, you know, but when I was watching that music video, I didn't see that high top-notch CGI effect. I thought it was a little bit caricature. Maybe he did that on purpose. Maybe that's his whole persona, because I saw some of the music videos and it's kind of similar. That's his whole thing. Maybe that's his theme. So I guess that's what he was going for. But me personally, I'm all about aesthetics. You know, I'm a very visual person. And when I'm watching CGI, especially when I'm watching movies, like especially American movies, I want to see top of the notch CGI, especially today in 2021. And I felt like I didn't get that. I feel like the effects, the CGI, the animation could have been better, but it didn't. You know, maybe that's his choice. The whole theatrics with the devil. All that shit, that necessarily doesn't really bother me. You know, twerking on the devil and dick riding the devil and things like that, that doesn't bother me. I really don't care what anybody does with themselves sexually or whatnot. The thing with me though is I'm very huge on spirituality. I'm huge on energy. When it comes to energy, you know, positive energy, negative energy, and I've talked about that on previous episodes, I don't like to mess around with things I don't understand. And like I said before, there are three different things that make up a person. You know, the physical, the mental, and the spiritual. The physical, we go to the gym. A lot of people go to the gym to stay fit and stay active. If you are going to the gym to work out and you don't know what you're doing at the gym, you're messing with the weights, you're messing with all kinds of shit, you're messing with your body, you can actually hurt yourself because you don't know what you're doing. Maybe you're going out there to have fun. It's like a kid going to the gym carrying lifting weights and doing all kinds of shit that they're not supposed to do because they don't understand what's going on. You can end up hurting yourself. The same thing too, I feel like when you're messing with spirituality, when you're messing with spiritual bodies, spiritual entities, when you're messing with energies that you don't understand because you're having fun, you can end up hurting yourself. You may not realize it right now, but eventually you may end up conjuring some dark shit into your life. And I feel like Lil Nas X, he was just having fun. He's naive. I don't think he's very spiritual, nor do I think he's religious. I don't think he cares or believes in God or the devil. I just think he's trying to troll people. You know, I think he wanted to get that shock factor because he knows that people will be talking. You know, you have a gay black man doing all kinds of sexual things on camera, you know, especially doing that sexual thing with the devil. So of course it's going to have the internet talking, and of course that's publicity, that's marketing, that will help with the sales. I don't know if it helped with the sales or if it didn't help with the sales. I don't have a problem with that, but I feel like that's what he went for, and he's definitely getting the attention that he wanted. You know, again, I don't know if it's helping with the sales or not. It is what it is. I also did see that he did release a shoe by Nike with Luke 10:18 with human blood and whatnot. Again, I don't think he believes any one of those things. It actually may not have real human blood. I think he's just doing all that for publicity, for attention, because he knows the shock factor would get people talking, and that's good for publicity, that's good for selling. Again, I feel like all this shit, this is just energy, this is all spirituality, this is all kinds of shit that you don't understand. He does not believe in, he does not understand, and I feel like you're just playing with fire. That's just me. Okay, anybody who knows me on a very personal level knows that me, Uche, I am extremely, extremely protective of my energy. I haven't always been like that, but ever since I done been through some hard shit, man, I've seen a whole lot of mess, and I've become so protective of my energy. I feel like your body will die, your mind will die eventually, but your spirit lives on forever. And for something as very powerful and very everlasting as your spirit, it is extremely important, and also my very universal and natural duty to protect my spirit, to protect my energy, because whatever I do right now, whatever I let anybody do to me right now, that shit will live on forever. That shit will follow me for all eternity. So I'm very, very protective of my energy. And again, that's the spirituality of me speaking. And I feel like me personally, just like when I go to the gym, when I work out, I only stick to things I know. I just do exercise that I know. I see some of the dudes and even some of the women working out and doing all kinds of shit that, you know, it looks cool from outside. From my perspective, it looks cool, but I know that I don't understand it. I don't understand the mechanism of all that. You know, I don't have the body or the mind or even the will or zeal to do all that shit. I just let the professionals do their things, you know, and I would not want to mess with none of that because I don't want to hurt myself or injure myself more than I already am. You know, same thing too when it comes to spirituality. There are certain things, certain energy, certain type of spiritualities, spiritual practice, I just stay away from. You know, certain things I just stay away from because I don't understand it, I don't believe it, I don't want to joke with it, because I don't want to end up conjuring some dark shit into my life. And that's the only thing I would say. I just feel like he doesn't know what he's doing, nor does he care, nor does he believe in what he's doing. I just hope that he does not get himself into trouble. That's the only thing I have about the video. The whole devil dancing with the devil thing doesn't bother me. The whole twerking thing doesn't bother me. The explicitness and all that shit, I don't even think it was that explicit, because I've seen some of these straight people have some of the most erotic. It'd be like watching porn, to be honest with you. When I see some of these celebrities, some of y'all A-list celebrities, some of y'all's top celebrities, you know, talking about my pussy this and my dick this and things like that, I don't see the difference. I feel like those people are actually way worse, but you make excuses for those people because they're straight. But anyway, I don't think it was that explicit. The imagery, that doesn't bother me. I just feel like the only thing is just when you start messing with energy, when you start messing with something that you don't understand or believe in, just because you don't believe in it doesn't mean it's not real. And when you start messing with something that you don't understand, it could come back and bite you. Another thing too, Lil Nas X, he's young. He's a young man. I have my own reservation about Hollywood. I've kind of talked about that in some of my previous episodes when I talked about war against spirituality. I don't want to go too deep into it so I don't get in trouble, but I just feel like there's a lot of dark shit in Hollywood that's been presented to us to look attractive. And I feel like if you're young and naive and you don't have some type of sense of discernment, you don't have a strong balance, it's so easy for you to get lost. You may not necessarily know it right now. He may not necessarily know it right now because he's popping. But the thing with Hollywood is they will sign you, they will push you forward because you're popping right now, until you're no longer popping, until somebody who was popping better than you comes along, they throw you in the trash can and then move on with somebody else. And I just hope that does not happen to him. Especially because he's a black gay man who is actually truly talented. I've seen a lot of artists who have no talent whatsoever. They may have sex appeal, but talent is zero. But this man, in my opinion, I think he's actually very talented. I'm not even a fan. You know, I just download songs if it sounds good, if it looks good, if I'm feeling it. I don't really follow him religiously, so I wouldn't really know his in and outs. But I do think that he's very talented, and he's got the looks too. He's got the body. I really hope that he does not fall off because of some dark shit that he's conjuring into his life. That's all I have to say about the music production. Again, to all the Christian bigots and all the Christian hypocrites who have something to say, something negative to say, because it has something to do with gay or LGBTQ. I've seen all kinds of reviews online, especially with black people. I feel like black people are more homophobic than any other race. I don't know why. I don't understand it, but maybe someday I may come to be enlightened. But I feel like when I see a lot of black people watching these videos and giving their little commentaries on the internet, the homophobia is just damn ridiculous. The disrespect is too damn much. So the people who have a problem with the music video, especially the people who also stand some of these celebrities, some of these straight celebrities who do way worse shit, talk about pussy popping and all kinds of nefarious shit on your music video, but then you have a problem with a man expressing his sexuality, eat a dick. That's the end of today's commentary. Please share down below. Let me know how y'all feel about the whole music production. Do you agree with me that the music is a bop? Do you agree with me that the lyrics is just okay? You know, it's nothing new, because we've all heard about drugs and alcohol and sex before one too many times. And do you agree with me that the CGI effects, the animation could have been better, but perhaps that is his style. If that's his style, that's okay. Either way, it's still okay. If he likes it, I love it. It is what it is. And do you agree with me with the whole spirituality commentary? Do you agree with me that he doesn't know what he's doing, nor does he believe in what he's doing? And just because he don't believe in it doesn't mean it does not exist. And when you play with fire, you have to expect to get burned. And I hope that he doesn't get burned. Please share your thoughts down below. Don't forget to like, comment, share with your friends and family. Please follow me on social media, Facebook and Instagram, Let's Talk with Uche. My website is www.letstalkaboutus.org. Feel free to send me an email at letstalkwithuche@gmail.com. Thank you very much. Until next time. Bye-bye.